Good evening, everyone. I'm Larry Kudlow. Welcome back to Kudlow & Company. We aim to be right on America, right on business, and right on the money. And yes, we still believe that free market capitalism is the best path to prosperity. On this evening's program, reasonably strong early holiday sales support the Goldilocks economy. It still looks like the greatest story never told. Inflation is plunging, but why didn't stocks like it? Are we headed for a trade war with China? Do we fear Democratic business bashing from the likes of John Deagle and Henry Waxman? Does this change the interest rate outlook from the Fed? And are we worried about Iraq? Of course we are. Joining me now to discuss, debate, and dissect is Donald Luskin, Chief Investment Officer at Trend Macro. John Augustine, Chief Investment Strategist at Fifth Third Asset Management. Doug Kass, President of Seabreeze Partners Management. And Gary Schilling, President of A. Gary Schilling & Company. Kimberly Greenberger is also out there, retail analyst for Citigroup. All right, we got it all. Gary Schilling, keeping me company on the set. My very first day back. Thank you for coming back on. Now, look, one of the surveys had total sales up 6%. That includes a lousy performance from Walmart. So the consumer looks to be alive and well. Your recession forecast is predicated on housing slumps, housing price deflation, and lousy consumers. Are you ready to rethink your scenario because consumers look good?
Oh, not at all. Quite the reverse, Larry. If you look at what's happening, people are not willing to admit that their houses are worth a lot less. The bids have disappeared. The people who want to buy houses have gone to the sidelines. But people think their houses are unique. They don't go by on the tape every day in terms of price. So they're sitting there, and their willingness to spend is a measure to the extent to which they are not facing reality. But reality started to step in this weekend, and it was really in Walmart. Walmart doesn't concentrate on the big ticket items that are giving away the Plaza TV screens. They sell a wide variety of merchandise, and that's where the middle and lower income people are being pinched. And to me, that's what's going on.
What about real wages? Real wages are rising the best in 10 years. Unemployment is low. What about that?
Hey, that's history. We're looking ahead here.
History? History was this past weekend with big sales.
No. When you look at those sales and you see the weakness at Walmart, Walmart is 10% of non-auto retail sales in this country. How big a sample do you need? That's really telling you that people are getting scared. And when they have actually declines in same-store sales, hey, no wonder stocks hit the skids today.
All right, John Augustine is, Gary Schilling says consumers are in denial about their homes. I wonder whether Mr. Schilling is in denial about the strength of consumer spending and the economy. What's your take, John?
Well, the consumers sure weren't in their home this weekend, I can guarantee you that, at least from the city I was in this weekend. They were all out at the mall. But Larry, we would agree with your assertion. We don't think that unemployment rate is too much history. We don't think wage gains are too much history yet. The consumer to us still seems strong. Yeah, we see housing activity lower in the country. We see prices of housing adjusting to meet supply and demand, but we don't see a case yet where the consumer has checked out.
Hey, Kimberly Greenberger, set these guys straight. What really happened? And by the way, is Walmart the biggest turkey or what?
They certainly had some turkey news for us this weekend, didn't
they? I mean,
they?
Kimberly, it's, you know what it is, Walmart, all the bears. I know Doug Kass is going to obsess about Walmart. You heard Gary Schilling obsess. All the bears obsess about Walmart. If they didn't have a Walmart, they'd have to invent one. My view about Walmart is gobble, 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 gobble. That's it, Kimberly. What's really happened out there this past weekend?
Well, we think that sales were okay. And in fact, the consumer appears very healthy to us. But what we noticed when we were out haunting the malls is that consumers were very much price promotion driven. And it seems to me like they were willing to grab the bargain when it presented itself. We think that that is somewhat a condition of the fact that we have a very lengthy shopping window between Thanksgiving and Christmas this year, a near record 31 days. So there just isn't any urgency to finish up my Christmas shopping here on the weekend after Thanksgiving. I've got a lot of weeks to get that taken care of.
Survey that said total sales are up 6%. Isn't that a big number?
That's a huge number. In fact, if we see same-store sales up 6% on Thursday, I think you'll see a very, very nice rally in retail. The shopper track data that you're referencing is basically traffic data, and they're interpreting the traffic trends to translate into sales trends. So we'll see if, in fact, they're correct in their claim this Thursday.
So Don Luskin, is the bottom line here for today's sell-off, which could, after all, just be a correction after 4 months of unbelievable gains. But let's just put that correction stuff aside. Does this mean that the consumer is so much stronger, Gary Schilling notwithstanding, and I'm going to preempt Doug Kass, and therefore the Federal Reserve will A, not lower rates, and B, not raise rates. Is that part of this stock market move today?
Yeah, that's the total story. The story here is that the economy just refuses to roll over and die, and the reality remains that the next interest rate move is going to be higher. And that's what today was all about.
How much higher and when higher?
It's probably not going to happen until the end of the first quarter of next year, but I think we're going to start moving up in 25 basis point hunks. We'll probably get to 6% and pause and look around and see what's left.
And
but that's where we're headed. Inflation is not going down fast enough.
10-year yields fell a couple basis points now, just above 450. I believe the closing quote today was 453. I believe they dropped 2 or 3 basis points. I like to use the long bond as my ultimate economic proxy.